Hello, in this video, we will see the biological membrane, how it separates two fluid compartments, and the fluid mosaic model. Let's get started. First, we will do a simple hypothetical experiment. Let's take water and put a drop of oil into it. We will assume that this oil is as heavy as water. Being hydrophobic, it won't dissolve in water and makes a sphere. Now let's take a dropper and put water inside this sphere. This water will stay inside the sphere of the oil. As the oil is hydrophobic, it won't allow the passage of water. So inside water stays inside and outside water stays outside. Thus, the oil has created two separate water compartments. The biological membrane that makes the wall of the cell is similar to this. It's also a sphere of lipid that separates inner and outer compartment. Of course, the real membrane has some differences from this simple oil. First, it's very thin. It's so thin that it's made up of only two layers of lipid molecules. That's why we call it lipid bilayer. And these lipid molecules are phospholipids. The phospholipids are better than hydrophobic lipids. In our experiment, we took hydrophobic lipid molecules. They want to stay away from the water. Here, molecules in the middle part of the layer are happy because they are away from the water. However, the innermost and outermost molecules are not comfortable because they are coming in contact with the water. This problem does not occur with phospholipid molecules because they are amphipathic. What does that mean? This is a phospholipid molecule. The lipid end of the molecule is hydrophobic. It wants to stay away from the water. However, the phosphate end is hydrophilic and it wants to stay in contact with water. So these molecules take such an orientation that makes both the ends happy. The lipid ends of all the molecules meet at the middle part of the layer. Here they stay happily away from the water. And phosphate ends come in contact with water on both the sides. So they are also happy. This smart choice of lipids and their orientation makes the membrane a more stable structure. However, in a broad sense, it's still just a sphere of lipid similar to the one that we created. Our experiment also helps understand the fluid mosaic model of biological membrane. See, I don't need to tell you that the oil making this sphere is in liquid state. The molecules in this layer are moving randomly as in any liquid. However, this movement can occur only within the layer. The molecules cannot escape into the water. The same is true for biological membranes also. It's also a liquid. Phospholipid molecules are moving randomly similar to what happens in any liquid. The special thing here is this movement occurs only within the layer. It's a two-dimensional movement within the plane of the layer rather than three-dimensional movement. In short, the biological membrane is liquid. Although strong and very thin, but still just a liquid. And this is the crux of fluid mosaic model. To summarize everything, biological membrane is a thin and strong layer of fluid surrounding the cells and organelles. And it is made up of amphipathic phospholipid molecules. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.